response to the mayor's task force on poverty, over the past 2 years, John Humphrey Center for Peace and Human Rights has brought together a team of young Edmontonians to provide direct input into End Poverty YEG. According to the United Nations Convention on the Rights of the Child, child participation is essential, and youth should be involved in the decisions that affect their lives. Using a human rights approach, poverty in this project has been viewed through four key pillars: justice, security, freedom, and dignity.
Here to ensure that the police service is using.
According to the UN Universal Declaration of Human Rights, Article 1 states, everyone is born free and equal in dignity and rights.
You know, I deeply believe in the notion of representation. And when I looked at the commission's director board, it's made up mainly of white individuals. And I think that there needs to be representations of various different backgrounds, and to make it more inclusive for people already in the police service to work their way up. Right? I feel that there's so many barriers that a lot of minorities have to go through. And sometimes a white individual, you know, and this is the reality of it, they might not understand or fully understand how those barriers may affect other people. And so just make it more inclusive and more representative of Edmonton.
Article 7 states, the law is the same for everyone and should be applied in the same way to everyone.
I think with proper education and proper information to them, then they will be able to adapt to it. But if we're not putting the initiative out there to inform them about the laws, about policing, about all this stuff, then how can we expect them to just automatically adapt? So I think it is about making sure that we are educating properly.
Article 8 states, everyone has the right to ask for legal help when their rights are not respected.
My name is Sonia Lal, and I'm a member of the Youth Action Project Justice. The reason I was here today is because I believe it's crucial to give a voice to police officers and also the minority community members. Currently, there are some rifts, so to say, between the police and the community, and our group is looking to seal that rift and find peace and understanding between both groups and offer help when needed.